so here are some of the hilts. This is Gunnamaniac's old hilt. It's for his master replica style one. The sound on this is not very good because there's not a lot of resonance holes to let the sound out, but you can see it's still got the light and everything like that. Very nice green. Oops, had a little bit of a problem that banging it together, and that could be because of the
battery pack,
but that's fine. But anyways, now you have, the new one. Very nice looking, okay? Now your first assumption, I'm assuming, is that it's all custom machined. And you'd be incorrect, because not all the parts on here are custom machined at all. In fact, there are very few that were. This is technically just another kind of sink tube-ish kind of setup, very similar to what I had here. This is part of Flange 3, I just have it apart because I'm working on the electronics and wanted to show you. There it is again, there's that 1.5-inch sink tube, okay? Bunch of holes in it. This is different because it's a 1.25-inch, and so it's a little bit tighter on the inside, but you can see it's still a sink tube, okay, with a lot of other different parts on it. Here he's kind of made it look Graflex looking, okay? You get this little kind of ribbed out section here. Was that part custom machine, Brian? Or?
No, I had to Dremel that out.
Okay, so there you go. He actually had a few of these parts, like a few of them cut to spec, but nothing fancy that you couldn't do yourself.
And
but anyhow.
He's going to demonstrate his Mara Jade or Mara Jade saber.
Mara Jade, yeah, my favorite right here. This is my baby. I love this one, love the design. Love parts design. Of course, I'm not as good as parts, but what I did with this one was I stuck with the 616 board. And did the RGB. I'm actually using Rebel on this one. I do the color wash. One of the really cool things that I like about this is right up the switch. You can barely even see the switch. Can you see the switch?
Wait, go ahead and show it, and then just I'll zoom in on it.
Right there.
Look at how small it is, and I'm going to zoom into it right now. And there you go.
And I'll switch on, barely disappears, and push back off again. And Novastar was giving it a great twirl earlier and trying to turn it off, and he probably spun this thing around for about 2-3 minutes straight before he finally forced the off of that, so it doesn't even get in the way. This is my baby. This will be here
turn him
to
on.
My son.
There you go. And that's a nice purple blade. I can confirm that, I mean, you know, there's pink and then there's purple, and this is definitely more on the purple side. It's a nice one. Not really sure how the video will come out on this showing all this, guys, but you know, you're just gonna have to go off of what we're telling you about what it looks like. Some of it's not gonna look exactly the way you imagine because of the lighting situations.
That's my mirror.
Excellent. There you go. But this new saber that Brian made is basically a better, more advanced replica of his older one. His new one is powered by CF, so why don't you go ahead and demonstrate that.
It's based off of a 1.25-inch sink tube saber with a whole bunch of aluminum overlays. So you get a layer look. I kind of cheated with craft aluminum sheets like this, and I hid where the seam is with an aluminum layer. Both sides.
And there you go, and we know that he's got the Black Star mode in there, and he can actuate a few clashes. Excellent, and then he can do some swings or something like that, you know.
Now the swings aren't all dialed in at the moment because I just put it together recently. But
there we go.
Yep.
And now he can shut his saber off really quick, and we'll demonstrate to you something fancy. Now, I can confirm that all he's doing is pressing the button. That's it. Turn it back on and then turn it off again. Wait, hold on, not yet. There we go. Now just turn it off again. There you go. Now he's going to hand it off to Graven. All right, Graven.
Nothing up my sleeve.
That's right.
And here we go. I am pushing the button. I am doing everything I can. Come on, baby, come on, turn on. I'm even talking pretty to him. I'm on your flow.
And Brian, go ahead and show him what only a true Jedi can do with their own saber.
I locked the saber with the Force. No one else can do it. My baby.
Now, that is not a trick at all. I mean, Graven can confirm he was pressing the button, same thing. Now, of course, we're being kind of tongue-in-cheek. I'm sure you guys can figure out that there's something going on. We're not going to tell you exactly what, but you might be able to catch it if you go through the CF wiring guide again. So anyways, there you go. Those are the Sabers. All right. He's got a whole bunch of Sabers here. Obviously, I've got some. Brian's got some out here, and we're just going to have some fun before telling you. Yeah, make the let it be light. We'll go ahead and light these babies up. As you can see in the back, the Luxian 5, that's the Luxian 5 saber I showed in the video, it's definitely bright. But, boom, there you have it. Probably all that light's drowned out all the hilts, but there's quite a few sabers in here. You can even see one yellow saber just right in there. Exactly. And that's an RGB that Graven has created for me, and pretty gnarly. Now, one thing to know is the MR boards will do their automatic shutoff at 2 minutes, but we're not even going to bother leaving them on quite that long. So, I guess... let's turn them down. Down they go. Well, that must be an ultra board. How did I know that? You can hear the differences between the flan shaders.
Okay, so this is the fantastic kind of sync tube, rainbow sync tube saber that Graven made for me. It's on a 1.25 inch sync tube, so it's extremely nice choke point for me all the way around. I love that. And also, you probably can't tell from there, but it's really light. I love this saber and its lightness. That makes it excellent. Basically, it's got the latching switch in here, and it's nice and hidden. I mean, you have this knurled knob here, but you can't accidentally touch it. The button is just nice and recessed in there, and as you can see, you got this nice, really cool kind of mace spike kind of thing on here. It's pretty great. So, both dangerous and cool at the same time. Love it. So we'll just turn on. This is at a yellow setting, and it's really nice. It's powered by an MR board. This is not, just so you guys know, it's not the RGB 616 mode. This is the normal MRFX thing. It's got a really good resonance, actually. I'm very surprised by it, too, because we've only got speaker holes out here in the back. It's kind of funny. I can feel some of the sound coming out some of the other little areas in here. So it's really cool. Obviously, you have all the nice crash noises and everything like that. Very nice. Now to demonstrate, if I can, I'll just turn you here to the rotary, and you can see now, instead of using the other dip switches that he had done in the past, and you guys have seen the video that he's done, we have the rotary, so I'll go ahead and swap out some colors now. I know you guys have seen some of that before, but it's always nice to see them. So we go to red. And the nice thing is you can have the good guy Jedi sounds with red that way. That way you don't have to have those disgusting, bad, horrible, Vader slash Maul sounds. Just bad. So this is good stuff. And now we go to a nice, kind of light Luke sky blue. Love that. Purple. Hopefully you'll see the difference on that one, but it's a nice, beautiful, royal bluish purple. I like that. And now we go to green. And now talk about the true purple. Oh, that's kind of the white, the whitish. That's nice. Very interesting. Where's that? There we go. Very much like his Mara Jade. I'd say it's a little bit more on the pink side with it, but I love it. It's a nice purple. Very good blade. So there you have it. The length, I think, even though it's kind of longer, you know, like this is probably about 15 inches or not, this is really awesome. I mean, just having this nice Dooku-style curvature to it, it just makes it really awesome. So you can get really good balance out of it, and you know, I feel comfortable wielding it, even though I never would have thought that I'd be comfortable wielding kind of a curved Dooku-ish type of saber. It feels like it could be used in stage combat, so you never know, you might see it for balance of power 3, you never know. Probably not wielded by me, because you know, I'm dead. So. I'm dead.
Sorry!
Alright, so there you go. Well, so this is Raven and Matthew, and it's Brian behind the camera. So let's toss each other some sabers. Have fun with your lightsaber.